guys, welcome back. You're with the team of New York, and here we are in conversation with all of us.
Okay, I've got an interesting question. It's not got much to do with the film, but I forgot the question. John, why didn't you ask a question?
Yeah, I think this is what I keep. A lot of people ask me in the interviews that we've been doing and the promotions that we've been doing and watching the film, and they say, what's so special about New York? And I ask them, I say, what do you think is so special about New York? Mm. And they keep telling me it's the casting. In a way, it's a very different kind of a casting that's come together for a film like this. It sounds very layman and it sounds very cliche, but a lot of people say it's very interesting to look at these different faces together in a film like this, because we're all known to have done different films.
How did you choose? I know you and John worked together in Kabul, so you had an equation, but how did you come up with Neil?
But
that has nothing to do
with this, absolutely.
Because, you know, that's one thing I keep saying in my interviews, because I'm a director with Yash Raj, I have this big luxury of being able to choose actors. You know, a lot of times in production houses, you have to make do with what you have.
Right.
But I think, yeah, I think what's really worked in this film is that all, not just the three of you, but even Irfan Khan, they're picking out from behind you. Yeah. You know, it just makes a very interesting poster. It makes a very interesting picture. You see these four faces and you are intrigued as to, you know, how have they all come together in a film like this? And also with the promos, you see the treatment of the film. To see, for example, Katrina in a film like this, you know, which is much more sort of, in a way, realistic compared to some of the other films that she's done in terms of the way she's dressing, the lack of makeup.
Lack of reflectors.
Lights.
I remember coming on the set, where are the lights?
Or John. I mean, John, in a sense, has been in the dramatic space before. Mm. But I think when you see the promo and you see the way John is sort of, the ease with which he's bonding with you and Neil, that is, I think, the differentiator. It suddenly brings John into a different space.
I have a question.
There's one question, sorry, I'm interrupting. There's one question I think everyone wants to ask you, and I think we want to ask you, is how did New York actually happen in the first place?
You know, the seed of the idea came from Adi, from Aditya Chopra, our producer, and this is after Kabul Express, and we were looking at options, and he had been living with this one idea, which he actually wanted to develop at a later stage. But he said, you know, I really like this one-line idea about these three friends and a certain situation. Would you like to develop it and sort of place it in your world? I mean, he knows I like to sort of take, you know, human stories and put them into sort of larger-than-life context. So he says, would you like to develop this? And when he first offered me this, I actually came back after a couple of days and said, no, I don't think this is going to work for me. And I started working on something else. And then when I was working on that other idea, suddenly this same one line came and, you know, sort of slapped me across my face. And I realized, you know, it can be set against this sort of contemporary New York setting. And I think it'll be great to be able to, you know, bring the backdrop and this human interest story together.
That's what I felt when I saw the film. I think I was the most overwhelmed person, because maybe they had seen the other, you know, the action parts and everything. But for me, that's what took me by surprise. Exactly that the film seems so much larger than what I read on paper.
Yeah.
Kabir, there's one more question that, you know, many people probably have in their minds, and it's a big question mark that I personally want to, you know, take away from them, is that your style of filmmaking is very guerrilla style of filmmaking. Normally, you know, that's what's going around with Kabul Express, people think, and unfortunately, they keep, you know, using a word documentary style. New York is definitely not that.
Yeah.
So was it a conscious effort that you've made with New York?
I react very instinctively to stories. I think every story needs a certain style of storytelling. And there is a certain style of storytelling that I think a very personal story like Kabul Express needed. And there is a certain more sort of higher dramatic and emotional pitch level of storytelling that New York needed. So, yeah, and I'm happy people in the promos have reacted to the sort of, of course, they term it slick and Hollywood. I don't know why they use that, because it's an assumption that we are not as slick.
No, it's also, Kabir, this is something, I mean, I've worked with you before, and on New York also, there's a certain way you get a message across to the audience, which is not forced. You never force the message through. You get it through to the audience very subtly, and that's what you've done in New York as well. So I think that's the Hollywoodish part of everything.
Not spoon feeding the audience.
He's not. You've not spoon fed the audience, but it strikes the audience so hard when they watch it.
I think when you even read the script, it did read as an issue-based film. I think it's just
not at all.
It's become very effective in its story of the three friends people are. You know, whoever seen the film is talking.
I'm glad you're talking about this because you know, again, there's this air of it being a very serious issue-based film.
Yeah,
but
I
personally think it's a beautiful story of three friends. You know, and it's one incident that completely changes their life. You know, there's so much color, there's so much vibrance, there's so much life in it. And,
in fact, yeah, some
it's
of the favorite
great.
Portions of my film
are the college
scenes,
portions.
You know,
I completely
the
connected
sense
with,
of fun
with that.
And
yeah.
warmth that is
but
there.
But my personal favorite is the climax because you know the reaction that we got when we sat there was that no one has ever seen a climax like this before.
Yeah,
true.
Which I think is amazing in itself.
But everything works because the college portion works.
Works, absolutely.
You know,
the strength
love,
of the friendship.
You fall in love with your characters.
I'm glad that the chemistry is really strong, you know, between, I mean, John, Katrina and myself, obviously, because we are friends, but also with Mr. Irfan Khan, because it's, you know, it's an honor to be working with him and sharing screen space.
Woh mera saman nahi hai. तुमको अभी अंदाजा नहीं है ये लोग तुम्हारे साथ क्या कर सकते हैं।
I don't think you see the impact of what Irfan is doing till you see it on screen.
Yeah.
Because when you're standing in front of him, I kind of thought he's paying attention?
Yeah.
And because he has a very natural way, he has a way of making the most dramatic dialogue seem very natural.
Yeah.
By kind of you know just looking around, and I thought, excuse me, hello. But and then when I saw it on screen, I was like, whoa, okay. Then I guess there's a reason, you know, he is Irfan Khan.
Anyways, we remain in conversation for New York and we'll take a short break and come back.